Hello students, welcome back to lecture 5 Bluetooth part 1 on Internet and Web Technology, course code 1619503, unit 1, review of network concept. Before going to the lecture, we will see the content of the lecture. So now we will see the content of the lecture. Introduction about the Bluetooth, Bluetooth specifications, Bluetooth applications, Bluetooth technologies, advantages and characteristics of Bluetooth. So now we will see that introduction of Bluetooth. So introduction, the Bluetooth is nothing but it's a wireless technology. So that is used to transfer data between different electronic devices. So the distance of data transmission is small in comparison to other known modes of wireless communication. So this Bluetooth technology that is eradicate the use of cords, cables, adapters and permit the electronic devices to communicate wirelessly among each other. So this is the image shows that that is no Bluetooth device. That is one of the devices that can be helped to receive the music. So there is a Bluetooth specifications. There is a two types of specification, core specification and the profile specification. Core specification that define the protocol stack and the requirements for testing and qualification of Bluetooth based product. That is core specification. The profile specification that defines usage models that provide detailed information about how to use the Bluetooth protocol for various types of applications. That is profile specifications. So first we will see that there is a core specification consists of 5 layers. First, radio layer, baseband layer, that is link manager protocol, that is LMP layer, and logical link control and adoption protocol, that is L2CAP, and service discovery protocol. First, we will see that radio layer. So radio, it is nothing but it specifies the requirements for radio transmission. That may be including frequency, modulation and power characteristics for a Bluetooth transceiver. And next one is no baseband layer. The baseband layer that is defined physical and logical channels and that is link type. Maybe it's a voice or data type. So that specifies the various packet formats. And that is no transmit and receiving timings, channel control, and the mechanism for frequency hopping and device addressing. So this baseband layer that is specified point to point or point to multipoint links. So the length of the packet that can be ranged from 68 bits to maximum of that is 3071 bits. So another one specification, link manager protocol, LMP. So that is define the procedure for link setup and ongoing link management. So next L2CAP, that is nothing but is a logical link control and adoption protocol. So this logical link control and adoption protocol is responsible for adapting upper layer protocols to the baseband layer. And final one, it's no service discovery protocol. So the service discovery protocol that is allow a Bluetooth device to query other Bluetooth devices for device information and the service provider and the characteristics of those services. There are different Bluetooth applications. You can see here there is a different images. The one first one is cordless desktop. The second one is ultimate headset. The third one is automatic synchronization. and fourth one is multimedia transfer. So we will see one by one. First, we are going to see cordless desktop. So cordless desktop, what is that? It is all of peripheral devices. All of peripheral devices. That all peripheral devices are connected to the personal computer cordlessly. So we can use mouse, keyboard, printer, speaker, etc. We can connect to the computer without cord. So that is cordless desktop. So second one application, that is ultimate headset, that can be used to allow one headset to be used with my RAID, that is devices, including telephones, portable computer, stereos, etc. So another one, that is automatic synchronization. You can use the see these images. So automatically synchronize the two Bluetooth devices. So this is the usage model makes use of the hidden computing pattern, which focuses on application in which devices automatically carry out certain tasks on behalf of the user without user intervention or awareness. So multimedia transfer, one of the Bluetooth applications, that multimedia transfer help the user to exchanging of multimedia data like songs, videos, pictures that can be transferred among devices using Bluetooth. You can see these images from this mobile to mobile or mobile to system. We can transfer the data like songs, videos, pictures, etc. So another one, Bluetooth technology. So Bluetooth technology is a wireless system that uses radio waves for communication purpose. So it has the capability to communicate with many different devices at once without interface. So it is an open standard for short-range transmission of digital voice and data support from point-to-point and multiplayer-to-point application. So it has a short-range radio link and the price is also low. So when two Bluetooth devices are in 50 meter range, then they can have the connection probability. When the Bluetooth is cut and the cord is used to in digital devices, it operates with the speed of 2.45 gigahertz. So for mobile phones and business users, the range is set at 10 to 100 meters. It is possible to increase the range. So the speed of the cross data rate, so 1 bit per second, and the speed of the second generation is increased up to 2 bits per second. So one-to-one Bluetooth connections are allowed for minimum speed of data transfer, which is 723 kilobits per second. So it has low power consumption. So this is the Bluetooth technology diagrams. There is a Bluetooth, that Bluetooth connected to the multiple different devices, that connected to the laptop, that connected to the desktop, and that is connected to the other devices like keyboard, mouse, etc. So the Bluetooth technologies support wireless point-to-point and point-to multiple devices. You can see these images point-to-point. So that is M means master, S means slave. Here this image shows that point-to-multiple links that shows that no master and there is a multiple slave. So now we will see that point to point. So point to point link has a master and the slave relation, and the Bluetooth function also same as the master and slave. So the figure shows that the master and the slave relation. So that is no point to point link. Now we will see that point to multiple links. It is the network that is formed by a master and one or more slaves. But the maximum number of slaves should be 7. So this diagram shows a clear picture of point to multiple links. So what are the advantages of Bluetooth? So advantages of Bluetooth, that is, offer economic wireless solution for short distances, maybe both data and voice. It is support both data and voice, and also it is used to in the mobile and the stationary environment. There is no set of file to install the Bluetooth. It is the inbuilt. It is an inbuilt device. So it is globally technologically no specification that are used. Characteristics of Bluetooth. So what are the characteristics? Up to 8 devices can be networked in the Piconote by using Bluetooth. So Piconote is nothing but more than one device that is connected to the one small network that is known as the Piconote. Okay, so the device is not to be pointed at each other. So our signals are omnidirectional. So the government regulated worldwide because it is possible to utilize the same standard. So signals can be transmitted even through walls and briefcases. So the summary of this lecture, hopefully in this presentation, you may have learned that what Bluetooth technologies and its application specification, advantages and the characteristics of Bluetooth. And dear students, go through this book and get lot of information from this book. Thank you.